Hello friends, welcome to Dev's Institute. Today we will see one more topic from computer networks, that is frequency division multiplexing. Before I start, I request you to subscribe to my channel and click on bell icon to get instant notification about the new videos. This is totally free of cost. Before going towards frequency division multiplexing, first we will see what is multiplexing. If bandwidth of a link connecting two devices is greater than the required bandwidth, then the link can be shared between different signals. So if you are trying to send signal from one device to another device, that signal will travel through a link. A link means a physical link. If the bandwidth of physical link is more than the bandwidth required to travel the signal, then the rest of the bandwidth gets wasted. So instead of wasting that extra bandwidth, what we can do is we can combine different signals and we can pass different signals through a same line at a time. So multiplexing is a technique that allows transmission of multiple signals through single data line simultaneously. Now we'll see how this happens. In multiplexing, this is the sender side. So consider there are n input lines, means there are n different signals. N different signals will be given to multiplexer. Multiplexer will multiplex this signal, means will combine these signals and will form one signal. That signal will pass through this channel. So this link, this is a physical link which has a greater bandwidth than the combined bandwidth required for these lines or these signals. So consider if these are 1, 2, and 3 signals, and each of these signal requires 4 kilohertz bandwidth, then 4 plus 4 plus 4. So total signal will require, means combined signal will require bandwidth 12 kilohertz. So now this link should be, or the bandwidth of this link should be greater than 12 kilohertz. In that case only, you can merge these signals into a single signal and current can transmit the signal through this channel. So these signals will be multiplexed, combined into a single signal, and that single signal will traverse to this line. At the receiver end, demultiplexer will segregate these signals one from another. So all signals will be separated and will be given to a particular host or a particular application at the receiver end. So this is how multiplexing works. Now there are different multiplexing techniques. Frequency division multiplexing, that is FDM, wavelength division multiplexing, WDM, synchronous and statistical time division multiplexing, that is TDM. Out of this, we'll first just focus on frequency division multiplexing, that is FDM, in this video. In later videos, we'll try to learn about WDM and TDM. So now what is frequency division multiplexing? Again, there will be a multiplexer at sender side. If there are n input lines, then your link will be divided into n number of channels. So now here consider that there are 3 input lines, so the channel will be divided into 3 link, sorry, not channel, link. This is entire link is divided into 3 different channels: channel 1, channel 2, and channel 3. Channels are separated by guard bands, so the range, bandwidth range, they are separated by some amount of bandwidth in between them, which is free of the signal. We'll see this in detail. So just for now, remember that channels are separated by the guard bands. So if there are three channels, two guard bands will be required. Similarly, if there are n channels, then you will require n minus 1 guard bands to separate those channels. So this entire signal will appear at demultiplexer, and demultiplexer will separate out the specific signals from the combined signal. Now we'll see the detailed procedure of FDM. I hope you all know the modulation process. In modulation, baseband signal, that is original signal. And one more thing, FDM is a analog signal. FDM is basically applied for analog signal. So analog signals will be considered in FDM process. You can apply it on digital signals also, but digital signals need to be converted into analog and then will be given to the FDM. So we all are aware of the modulation process. In modulation process, baseband signal is modulated using carrier signal and we get the modulated signal. Here we are performing frequency modulation. So this is my baseband signal and this is my carrier signal. Baseband signal modulated with carrier signal will give the modulated signal. So any modulation technique can be used. So this is frequency modulation. Means in frequency modulation you can use any, that is SSB, DSB, FC, any technique you can use, but the modulation should be frequency modulation as this is FDM. So this is baseband signal, this is my carrier frequency and this is the modulated signal. Similarly here it is second signal, but the frequency of carrier is different. So this frequency and this frequency is different. So again this signal will be modulated using carrier frequency F2 and you get modulated signal. And for third signal, this is carrier frequency F3 and you get modulated signal. Now after you get modulated signals for all the original signals, all these modulated signals are added. This is the process of multiplexing and you get the single signal. Now this single signal will travel through a link to the receiver. Now at the receiver end, this signal will be given to demultiplexer. Now what demultiplexer will do? Demultiplexer will first apply filter by using this same frequencies. So this filter will be applied and you get the modulated signal. This and this. You get the three different modulated signal. Three different modulated signal will be given to demodulator, and demodulator will give you the baseband signal, that is original signals. So this is how you get the original signal at the receiver end. Now we'll see some of the examples, means problem solving on this FDM. Assume that a voice channel occupies a bandwidth of 4 kilohertz. We need to combine 3 voice channels into a link with a bandwidth of 12 kHz from 20 to 32 kHz. Show the configuration using frequency domain. Assume there are no guard bands. So now see how many voice channels are there. 3 voice channels are there, each of bandwidth 4 kHz. Now the bandwidth of a link is 12 kHz. So 4 plus 4 plus 4 is 12 and link bandwidth is also 12, and it is considered that there is no guard band. So 12 kHz is sufficient and the range given is 20 to 32 kHz. So now we'll see the solution. See, these are 3 voice channel of 4 kHz frequency each. So 4 kHz, 4 kHz, 4 kHz. They will be given to modulator. Now the bandwidth of a link is 12 kHz and it is from 20 to 32 kHz. So first 4 kHz, 20 to 24 are assigned for link 1. 24 to 28 are assigned for link 2 and 28 to 32 are assigned for link 3. They all are combined and you get the total bandwidth 12 kilohertz total bandwidth from 20 to 32 kilohertz. Now this entire signal will travel through a link, high bandwidth link, and at the receiver end it will be given to bandpass filter, and bandpass filter will filter it out from 20 to 24, 24 to 28, 28 to 32. They will be given to demodulator and you get the actual signal 0 to 4, 0 to 4, 0, means 4 kilohertz, 4 kilohertz, 4 kilohertz, 3 lines of the voice channel. Okay. Now, one more example. 5 channels, each with 100 kilohertz bandwidth, are to be multiplexed together. Which is, what is the minimum bandwidth of link if there is a need for guard band of 10 kilohertz between the channel to prevent the interference? So 5 channels of each 10 kilohertz, so you will require 10 into 5, 10 kilohertz into 5, so 5 into, sorry not 10, it's 100, 100 into 5, that is 500 kilohertz. This is required for channels, 5 channels each with 100 kilohertz, so 5 into 100, that is 500, plus as there are 5 channels, you will require 4 guard bands to separate it from each other, so 4 guard bands, and guard band bandwidth is 10 kilohertz, so 4 into 10, so that is equal to 500 plus 40, that is 540 kilohertz. So some types of example can be asked in a university question. So practice same type of examples at home. Then the last point in FDM is analog carrier system. To maximize the efficiency of their infrastructure, telephone companies have traditionally multiplexed signal from lower bandwidth lines onto higher bandwidth lines. In this way, many switched or leased lines can be combined into fewer but bigger channels. So this is FDM is used in a telephone system in order to minimize the number of links, and lower bandwidth links are combined to merge into higher bandwidth links. So now see here analog hierarchy. So consider there are 12 voice channels, 12 ends, each with 4 kilohertz capacity. So 4 plus 4 means 4 into 12, it will be 48 kilohertz. So this 12 voice channel will be grouped into single group, we name it as a group. 5 such groups means each group with the 12 voice channel and 48 kilohertz bandwidth will be grouped into super group. Okay, 10 such super groups. So now here there are 12 voice channel and 5 groups. So 12 into 5. So there will be 60 voice channel and 48 into 5. That is 240 kilohertz total bandwidth. They form subgroup. 10 such subgroups form master group. So in master group there will be 600 voice channel, 60 into 10. And 240 into 10, that is 2.52 megahertz. And 6 such a master group forms the jumbo group. So each time now you see the bandwidth of a line is increased so that the number of channels will increase. So here a jumbo group is a single link which contains the 3600 voice channel. So this is how the telephone line hierarchy is maintained. So this is all about FDM. In next video lecture, we'll study WDM and TDM in detail. Thank you very much for watching my video. If you like my video, please press like button given below the video. If you have any queries, you can ask me through comment section. Happy learning. Thank you.